Fournette. Fournette goes airborne. He's in. Touchdown, Jaguars.
Tip and intercepted by Ramsey to close it out.
It's over. The Jacksonville Jaguars have pulled off the upset of the playoffs.
What is going on, everybody? It is Treeb from Treeb Talks, and on this beautiful Tuesday morning, again, we are not going to be going over five things that we learned from the Houston Texans game. Instead, we're going to be talking about a topic a lot of Jaguar fans in the community are already talking about, and that is trades. We are going to be going over five positions that the Jaguars should trade for before the trade deadline hits. So without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, let's hop right into the video. I am Treeb from BigJReport.com, and these are five positions the Jaguars should try to upgrade before the trade deadline. Number five, linebacker. Now, this is not to say Telvin Smith and Miles Jack are bad players or haven't had a good year overall. However, Telvin Smith has been struggling this season, and it's hard to necessarily find an upgrade, but it wouldn't be bad to trade for a linebacker that may improve this team's depth. So, you know, Telvin Smith isn't on the field 100% of the time. Same goes for Miles Jack, Leon Jacobs, etc. I think that this is a position the Jaguars could improve depth-wise. They do have guys like Donald Payne that are currently backing them up, but I think they lack true depth at the linebacker position. And though Telvin Smith is struggling, if he were to go down, we would be down to a really lesser linebacker. So to trade for a linebacker that is a perennial starter in this league to be able to come in and fill a role of depth and maybe get some playing time in between, I think it's smart if the Jaguars went after a decent linebacker before the trade deadline. Coming in at number four, we have the cornerback position. Again, not to say Jalen Ramsey or A.J. Boye. Neither one of their jobs is threatened, but D.J. Hayden's already proved he's injury-prone. Tyler Patman is also on the shelf, and though I'm kind of intrigued to see what Ronnie Harrison could really do at a nickel corner position, I think the Jags ought to bring somebody in that could really be a three-headed monster. That's something that I think this defense lacked. I talked about it a little bit in my recap video, that I didn't think Aaron Colvin really made that much of a difference. But AC is a number one corner on anybody else's team. So that those three corners of Jalen Ramsey, AJ Boye, and Aaron Colvin were an elite trio. And I think that's what the Jags really need to get back. Because as of right now, they are really picking on the nickel cornerback. Except for, at least when we're in man coverage, when they're in zone coverage, they just pick the easy zone, but that's neither here nor there. They usually will pick on Tyler Patman or DJ Hayden, and they will usually, more often than not, get beat, especially Tyler Patman recently. He's been getting beat quite a bit. But if we had a third corner that was kind of a lockdown guy and could be able to have a real three-headed monster at the three cornerback positions, I know that we did pay DJ Hayden a lot of money, but trading DJ Hayden away also may not be a bad idea. Guys like Patrick Peterson are currently on the trading block. I don't think we would trade for such a blockbuster player like Patrick Peterson, but could you imagine the trio of Jalen Ramsey, AJ Boye, and Patrick Peterson? Nobody would want to throw on that Jaguar defense. Coming in at number three, a position I don't personally agree with that we should trade for, but I know a lot of Jaguar fans will spark up a conversation if I don't include the position, so we're going to be talking about the quarterback position. Like I said, I'm kind of taking an outside point of view for this one because I know a lot of Jaguar fans really, really, truly believe we should be trading for a quarterback. In my honest opinion, there really isn't a quarterback out there that we could trade for that would make such an instant impact. Guys want to bring up guys like Teddy Bridgewater. They want to bring up guys like Derek Carr, Tyrod Taylor, I've even seen. And really, all three of those guys aren't going to get this franchise to where it needs to be either this year or the following years. And none of them are significant upgrades from Blake Bortles. You're not going to be able to get a guy like Drew Brees, Tom Brady, you know, Philip Rivers, Carson Wentz, the elite quarterbacks of the world. So I really do not think it's worth it to trade for a quarterback position, but I do see where the frustration lies with Blake Bortles' play, as well as, you know, people still are a little shaky on Cody Kessler. I personally am not. I want to see how Cody Kessler will do. But, like I said, I understand that some fans would want a quarterback for the Jags to trade for, but with all the quarterbacks that are currently on the trade block, at least, none of them are instant upgrades, and none of them will help us get to the promised land more than Blake Bortles or Cody Kessler would. Coming in at number two, we have the wide receiver position. Again, I don't really know the wide receivers that are on the depth chart, but these wide receivers are all so mediocre, and the Jags, like I said, just in the offseason, we need a true number one guy so all these other wide receivers can get masked up and really get open. And though there is a wide receiver like Dez Bryant that is still currently a free agent, I think it's obvious, kind of like Colin Kaepernick, that no one in the NFL is really going to want to touch Dez Bryant. Whatever that reason is, I don't really know, but I think us as fans and people that are fans of NFL teams that need a wide receiver, you should really just be giving up on the fact that Dez Bryant will come to your squad, because just for some reason right now, he is exiled from the NFL. Not quite sure why that is, but that just seems like the way she goes as of right now. There are tons of teams that are deep at the wide receiver position that we could really take a crack at and would be a true number one wide receiver in Jacksonville. And I think that that's what we need. Like I said, we need a true number one guy, a true number one talent. We need to go somewhere where a guy is not happy. And I know one guy that's been struggling a little bit, Buffalo Bills' wide receiver, Kelvin Benjamin. I think Kelvin Benjamin would bring a lot of moxie, I guess, experience a little bit at playing the number one wide receiver position to Jacksonville. He's still young. And I think that he would make a pretty big impact in the Jaguars wide receiver room. That's just one wide receiver that I think the Jags should take a crack at. Mostly because, you know, he got traded to Buffalo. He's kind of struggling. He's on a struggling team. Let's bring him into Jacksonville, see what he can do, see if he can kind of get his swagger back from his Carolina days. But I definitely think a wide receiver is something the Jags should improve on. This 2018 draft class as a whole has kind of been a big slap in the face. DJ Chark has kind of been bad to mediocre. And, you know, Taven Bryan hasn't done too well. And DJ Chark was really that guy that we were hoping would emerge to be a number one wide receiver at some point in this season, and we are about at the halfway point of the season coming into next week, and he has not done that. So I think the front office really needs to just swallow their pride right now, because I think that if you're not a homegrown Jaguar, they're like Vince McMahon, WWE, you know, if you're not a homegrown talent, we don't want to mess with you, you know, and that's just kind of the way she goes. And these wide receivers are all homegrown talent, except for Dante Moncrief. So we are going to have to go out and trade for a big wide receiver, because we desperately need a true 50-50 guy and a guy that will actually catch the football. And coming in at number one by any means necessary, let's go get another offensive lineman. I am so upset with how this offensive line has performed recently, even when they were all healthy, man. Last year, giving up only 24 sacks, which is a franchise low. Coming into the season, a lot of people expected this unit to be a top five unit in the NFL, including myself, and a lot of my before the season started, so yeah, preseason videos, you know, I was talking about how this offensive line is going to be really the anchor of this Jaguars team. But, you know, it hasn't been. The injuries have happened. You know, we got Josh Walker. I don't know what the deal with Eric Flowers is, if he's, like, really bad and we're just not playing him because he's not ready. But with that being said, I really think any offensive lineman that is worth a shit that's on the trading block, the Jags should go and get. You know, we signed Eric Flowers, who was a free agent, to a one-year contract, which was kind of smart for a depth pickup, and, you know, a pickup that is probably a little bit better than what we have currently, but we really need to trade for that dude that'll help our offensive line be really solid. Guys like Andrew Norwell, you know, a key acquisition this year, an all-pro guard last season, has really, really struggled also this season. So we need a couple of guys on this offensive line to really be franchise pieces, and as of right now, the Jags currently don't have that. And that's why I think offensive line is the most pressing need for the Jags and the number one position that the Jaguars should trade for. And that was five positions the Jaguars should upgrade by the trade deadline. What'd you guys think? Leave your comments down below. Don't forget to check the links down below as well. Don't forget to like me on Facebook at Treeb Talks. Follow me on Twitter at Trevon Pixley. And follow me on Instagram at Trayvon Pixley. Also, if you are feeling oh so generous, don't forget you can donate on Patreon. That's patreon.com/Treeb Talks, where I will be dropping exclusive Treeb Talks content that only you will be able to see with any amount of donations. Also, don't forget to hit that subscribe button, click the bell icon so you get notified every single time I drop a new video. I drop new Jaguar content on this channel 6 days a week. Ain't nobody outworking me. Those are just straight facts. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and as always, you guys have a terrific day.